In this tutorial, we will see briefly about exponential regression. Exponential regression is a type of regression that can be used when you face the following situations. The first one is exponential growth. That means growth that starts or begins slowly and then tends to accelerate rapidly without a bound. The second one is the second situation is exponential decay. That means decay begins rapidly and then slow down to get closer and closer to zero. So this tutorial will show you how to perform the exponential regression. So the equation of an exponential regression model is y is equals to a times b the power of x, where y is the response variable and x is the predictive variable, while a and b are the regression coefficients that describe the relationship between x and y. So let's jump to analysis. First, you have to create data. Let's create a fake data, and the x variable is 1 tends to 20, and the y variables is here is the numerical value. So type this one and run. Maybe you have different format or in Excel or in CSV, so whatever, the principle is the same. So again, run this one. So if you want just to visualize the data, that means it is better to create a quick scatter plot to visualize the relationship between x and y, whether it is exponential or not. So to do that, you have to type plot, and here is x followed by comma and y. So let's see, on the right side, the thumb image is displayed. So from this plot, we can see that there exists a clear exponential growth pattern between the two variables. It starts slowly and grows rapidly. So this seems like a good idea to fit an exponential regression equation to describe the relationship between the variables. So the next step is to fit the regression or the exponential regression model. So to do that, you can give any name that you want. W is WAC is the name, it's object. So you can use less than hyphen or is equals to, then LM, and under here we can use the LM function to fit an exponential regression model, and also using the natural, here is a natural log of y as a response variable and x as a predictor variable. So type this one and run. So it will give you something. Yeah. So in order to view the output of the model, so you have to say summary, and the name that I'm given for such model is WAC. So run this one to display some result on the console. So let's maximize it and see what is the result look like. So the overall F value of the model is 204, and the corresponding P value is around 2.917 10^-11, which indicates that the model as a whole is very useful. So thank you for watching, and if you have any question, you can address through my email wakjiraatasfahun@gmail.com, or alternatively you can use YouTube comment box.